Okay, so here I have a calculator and a pile of post-its and a orange Dodge Charger and this rubber thing that are all sitting on top of that rotating platform. So this platform will rotate, and the only reason these things are still on the platform is, of course, because there is some friction between them and the thing. So as I start to spin this, then we find that we need some centripetal force. Well, since the car had wheels on it, that was the easiest one to fling off. But what happens is, as we start to spin it, the only reason that they're going to stay in motion in a circle and not in a straight line motion like the car immediately tried to do is because of friction. And so friction is holding it on. But as I spin it faster and faster, what happens is I need more and more centripetal force to hold me in place to keep me moving in a circle. So we find that the things that have the least amount of friction, the least amount of grip, are going to fly off the first. And so the calculator had the best amount of grip here. And so eventually you're always going to spin around and around and around, and you're going to find some speed where the friction just matches the amount of centripetal force you need. And of course, if we start spinning faster than that, if the centripetal force that I need is bigger than the friction is providing, then you're going to go flying right off. As long as you have equal or more friction than what you need to hold you in place to provide that centripetal force, then you'll stay on.